وأقول في القرآن ما جاءت به آياته فهو الكريم المنزال. وأقول قال الله جل جلاله والمصطفى الهادي ولا أتأول.
الحمد لله رب العالمين، له الحمد الحسن والثناء الجميل، وأشهد أن لا إله إلا الله وحده لا شريك له، يقول الحق وهو يهدي السبيل، وأشهد أن محمدا عبده ورسوله صلى الله عليه وعلى آله وأصحابه والتابعين لهم بإحسان إلى يوم الدين، أما بعد. إن شاء الله تعالى I'm going to resume the episode of the series which I started on extracting benefits from the hadith of the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام. And inshallah ta'ala, this is going to be al-waqfatu al-thalitha, the third benefit or glimpse in which we can take from the hadith inshallah ta'ala, and that is amalun yaseer wa ajrun kabeer, that a small good deed that you do can have a very big reward for it. Yani a small deed that you do can have a very big reward with it. Akhil habib al-arib, my brother and my sister, إذا كسلت على عبادة من العبادات أو قربة من القربات, my brother and my sister, if you're ever lazy from doing any acts of worship or a deed that will get you closer to Allah تبارك وتعالى, ترى المشقة فيها والتعب, you see in it hardship and it requires energy from you and you don't have it in you. Like for example, كطول القيام, like standing for a long time in a prayer. أو كثرة الصيام, or fasting a lot. You see it to be something very hard. And what I want to say to you is, that shouldn't mean there are other good deeds that you could do that would bring you a lot of reward. فلا تفوتنك, do not let it go by you, عبادات يسيرة بأجور كبيرة, acts which are very easy to do but they have a lot of reward to it. Like ذكر الله, remembering Allah تبارك وتعالى, والصلاة على رسول الله, sending salutation on the Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم for example, أما وعيادة المريض, visiting a sick person, وإعانة المسكين, or helping a poor person, a person in need. أما والنصيحة الحائرين, advising those who are confused or يعني who need help. والصدقة على الفقراء والمعوزين, or giving charity to those who, or giving money to those who are in need. وبر الوالدين, being obedient towards your parents. وغيرها من العبادات والقربات لرب البريات سبحانه وتعالى حتى لا تحرم ذا وذا. So those easy deeds, they get a lot, you get a lot of reward for it. So don't let those rewards miss you. This hadith, which is in front of us, we mentioned in it that the woman, when she entered upon her mother Aisha, what did she do? It mentions the narration, فشقت التمرة التي كانت تريد أن تأكلها بينهما. The date in which she was holding the mother, she split it in half. She gave one to her first daughter and then she gave the second daughter the other part of, or the other side or the other portion of the date. This is a very simple deed, right? But the hadith mentioned to us the reward she received, this mother. إِنَّ اللَّهَ قَدْ أَوْجَبَ لَهَا بِهَا الْجَنَّةِ أَوْ أَعْتَقَهَا بِهَا مِنَ النَّارِ. Because of this one action that this woman did, Allah has made it a must for her to enter Jannah. Or Allah freed her neck from the hellfire. So it is عَمَلٌ يَسِيرٌ وَأَجْرٌ كَبِيرٌ, صح؟ Very small action she did, she got a lot of reward for it. This concept of small deeds, a lot of reward, has come in many hadith of the Prophet alayhi salatu wasalam. For example, go to the hadith in Sahihayn, Bukhari and Muslim, min hadithi Adi ibn Hatim radiyallahu ta'ala anhu. He said, قَالَ سَمِعْتُ رَسُولَ اللَّهِ صَلَّى اللَّهُ عَلَيْهِ وَسَلَّمَ يَقُولُ اِتَّقُوا النَّارَ وَلَوْ بِشَقِّ تَمْرَةٍ. اِتَّقُوا النَّارَ, fear the hellfire. وَلَوْ بِشِقِّ تَمْرَةٍ, even if it's the split of a date, even if it's very small. Okay. Also Allah تبارك وتعالى, He says in Surah Zalzalah, فَمَنْ يَعْمَلْ مِثْقَالَ ذَرَّةٍ خَيْرًا يَرَى. Anyone who does righteous deeds, even if it's a ذَرَّة, a mustard seed, very small, يَرَى, that person will see it the day of judgment. Ibn Abi Hatim, he said, حَدَّثَنَا أَبُو زُرْعَة. Ibn Abi Hatim is Abdul Rahman Ibn Abi Hatim. He's saying, حَدَّثَنَا أَبُو زُرْعَة, يعني أبو زرعة الرازي told him, that he said, قال حدثنا يحيى بن عبد الله بن بكير قال حدثني ابن لهيعة قال حدثنا عطاء بن دينار عن سعيد بن جبير في قول الله تعالى فمن يعمل مثقال ذرة خيرا يره ومن يعمل مثقال ذرة شرا يره وذلك لما نزلت هذه الآية وَيُطْعِمُونَ الطَّعَامَ عَلَى حُبِّهِ مِسْكِينًا وَيَتِيمًا وَأَسِيرًا كَانَ الْمُسْلِمُونَ يَرَوْنَ أَنَّهُمْ لَا يُؤْجَرُونَ عَلَى الشَّيْءِ الْقَلِيلِ إِذَا أَعْطَوْهُ فَيَجِيءُ الْمِسْكِينُ عَلَى أَبْوَابِهِمْ فَيَسْتَقِلُّونَ أَنْ يُعْطُوهُ التَّمْرَةَ وَالْكِسْرَةَ وَالْجَوْزَةَ وَنَحْوَ ذَلِكَ فَيَرُدُّونَهُ ويقولون ما هذا بشيء إنما نؤجر على ما نعطي ونحن نحبه. Ibn Abi Hatim, he mentions with his chain of narration from Sa'id ibn Jubayr that the ayah فَمَنْ يَعْمَلْ مِثْقَالَ ذَرَّةٍ خَيْرًا يَرَهُ وَمَنْ يَعْمَلْ مِثْقَالَ ذَرَّةٍ شَرًّا يَرَهُ, it came down regarding when Allah said, وَيُطْعِمُونَ الطَّعَامَ, they give food. عَلَى حُبِّهِ, they give it to. عَلَى حُبِّهِ مِسْكِينًا وَيَتِيمًا وَأَسِيرًا. So some of the people, some of the Muslims, they used to believe that they will not be rewarded. لَا يُؤْجَرُونَ عَلَى الشَّيْءِ الْقَلِيلِ إِذَا أَعْطَوْهُ. If they give out something very small, they will not be rewarded for it. That's what they believed. فَيَجِيءُ الْمِسْكِينُ عَلَىٰ أَبْوَابِهِمْ, so a poor person will come to their door. فَيَسْتَقِلُّونَ أَنْ يُعْطُوهُ التَّمْرَةَ, so they would not give him, they would find it يعني little to give him a date. So يعني some, this is nothing to give somebody, but they won't do that. فَيَرُدُّونَهُ, so they will turn him back. وَيَقُولُونَ, and they will say, ما هذا بشيء, this is nothing. إنما نؤجر على ما نعطي ونحن نحبه, we are going to be rewarded in what we give and that we love. And this is something small, we don't love it, it's insignificant, why would Allah reward us for it? Listen to this famous and fascinating hadith from our Prophet Muhammad ibn Abdullah صلى الله عليه وسلم. He said, من تصدق بعدل تمرة من كسب طيب ولا يقبل الله إلا الطيب وإن الله يتقبلها بيمينه ثم يربيها لصاحبها كما يربي أحدكم فلوه حتى تكون مثل الجبل. This hadith, Al-Imam Malik narrated in his Muwatta, and the hadith is aslan in Sahih al-Bukhari and Muslim fi Sahihayn, that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, anyone who gives out the equivalent of a date from a halal income, And Allah does not accept, Allah will not accept from you something unless it is good. Only thing Allah will accept is that which is طيب. وَإِنَّ اللَّهَ يَتَقَبَّلُهَا بِيَمِينِ Allah will accept it from you with His right hand. And Allah will nurture it for you, subhanahu wa ta'ala, until it becomes a mountain. Until it becomes a what? Until it becomes like a mountain. I mean, that small date that you gave, but equivalent to that small date, Allah will make it more than it is for you. It's also mentioned, and the miskinan istat'ama Aisha. A miskin asked Aisha for food. Al-Mu'mineen, Aisha radiallahu ta'ala anha. And in front of her was a inab, a grape. فَقَالَتْ لِإِنسَانٍ She said to someone, خُذْ حَبَّةً فَأَعْطِهِ إِيَاهَا And you take one and give it to them. فَجَعَلَ يَنْظُرُ إِلَيْهَا وَيَعْجَبْ So the person kept looking at the grape because they saw it to be little, right? فَجَعَلَ يَنْظُرُ إِلَيْهَا وَيَعْجَبْ He kept looking at it, fascinating. Fascinated. فَقَالَتْ She said, Allahu Akbar, فَقِيهَا She's a very knowledgeable woman. She said, أَتَعْجَبُ كَمْ تَرَى فِي هَذِي الْحَبَّةَ مِنْ مِثْقَالِ ذَرَّةِ Are you fascinated at what amount of يعني weight of مِثْقَالِ يعني the small mustard seed of weight that this little حبة has? And Imam Malik mentions this in his Muwatta. And the reward is big. And what Allah Tabarak wa Ta'ala is the Day of Judgment is going to be what? The reward is mithqala dharra, Aisha is talking about. How much mithqala dharra is a date? It's heavier than a dharra. Huh? Radiallahu ta'ala. It's also narrated عن سعد بن أبي وقاص أنه تصدق بتمرتين فقبض السائل يده فقال فقبض يده It was mentioned سعد بن أبي وقاص He gave out two dates a sadaqah. فقبض السائل يده فقال للسائل He grabbed the hand of the questioner and he said to the questioner ويقبل الله منا مثاقيل الذر وفي التمرتين مثاقيل ذر كثيرة الله أكبر Allah accepts from us mustard seed of weight and the weight that is inside The date is far bigger than that. And Imam al-Qurtubi mentions it in his Al-Jami' al-Ihkam al-Qur'an. فَيَنْبَغِي عَلَى الْعِبَادِ It is upon the people, my brothers and sisters, أَنْ يَسْتَشْعِرُوا فِي الدُّنْيَا To feel that what is in this dunya, whatever is in your hands, هُوَ رِزْقُ اللَّهِ Is Allah's rizq. فَلَا يَجُوزُ أَنْ يَبْخَلُوا بِإِنْفَاقِهِ It's Allah's rizq. But it's not permissible for you to be stingy with what is Allah's. Especially what Allah commanded you to give. فَقَبِيحٌ أَن يُمْنَعَ It's very evil for someone to refuse to give to Allah that which is Allah's. Allah said in the Qur'an, يَا أَيُّهَا الَّذِينَ آمَنُوا أَنْفِقُوا مِمَّا رَزَقَنَاكُمْ مِنْ قَبْلِ أَن يَأْتِيَ يَوْمٌ لَا بَيْعٌ فِيهِ وَلَا خُلَّةٌ وَلَا شَفَاعَةٌ وَالْكَافِرُونَ هُمُ الظَّالِمُونَ سورة البقرة Allah also says subhanahu wa ta'ala وَأَنْفِقُوا مِمَّا رَزَقْنَاكُمْ مِنْ قَبْلِ أَنْ يَأْتِيَ أَحَدَكُمُ الْمَوْتِ Give from what Allah has given you subhanahu wa ta'ala before death comes to you. وَلِنْتَأَمَّلْ هَذَا الْمَوْقِفِ Let's really observe this situation of our mother Aisha radiallahu anha what she did. And Imam al-Bukhari narrated in his Sahih min hadith Abi Huraira أن رجلا رأى كلبا يأكل الثرى من العطش فأخذ الرجل جفه فجعل يغرف له به حتى أرواه فشكر الله له فأدخله الجنة The Prophet صلى الله عليه وسلم said to us and told us that a man saw a dog who was very thirsty. He didn't have anything. So a man took what? His shoe. And then he started to what? Get water in there. And he kept giving it to the dog. Hatta until arwahu, he quenched the thirst of the dog. فَشَكَرَ اللَّهَ لَهُ. The animal shows gratitude, right? And this was a cause for him to what? فَأَدْخَلَهُ الْجَنَّةِ. Allah put him in Jannah. And Imam al-Bukhari narrated. That's fascinating, right? That small deed was a cause for him to enter Jannah. But what's also fascinating is the riwayah of Sahih Muslim. أَنَّ مْرَأَةً بَغِيًّا. A woman who was a prostitute. رَأَتْ كَلْبًا فِي يَوْمٍ حَارٍ. She saw a dog on a hot day. يُطِيفُ بِبِئِرٍ قَدْ أَدْلَعَ لِسَانَهُ مِنَ الْعَطَشِ. She saw a dog whose tongue was out of thirst, really wanted water. فَنَزَعَتْ لَهُ بِمُوقِعَهَا فَغُفِرَ لَهَا. What this woman did is when she went to the well, she gave him water, quenched the thirst of that dog. She's a prostitute. She charges people a service of fornication or adultery. Something very evil, right? Something not that Islam only prohibits, something even the fitrah doesn't allow. And a prostitution is worse than just having a boyfriend and girlfriend. The boyfriend and girlfriend is with one person. Someone goes through men after men for money. He was forgiven. For what? For that action she did. So I want you to all, inshallah ta'ala, to think over that point. To really ponder. Hafidhak Allah. May Allah preserve you all. This is a tasadduqun min baghiyin. It's the charity of a prostitute. Sah? Who is the al-mutasaddaqu alayh? Who is the one that the sadaqah was done for? Kelbun, a dog. What is it that that she gave? Yani al-mutasaddaqu bihi. What was the thing that she gave? Water, sah? But what was the reward? جَنَّةٌ عَرْضُهَا السَّمَاوَاتِ وَالْأَرْضِ. The woman, her status is what? As the hadith mentioned, بَغِي, number one. The thing or what she took care of was a dog. الْمُتَصَدَّقُ عَلَيْهِ is a dog. وَالْمُتَصَدَّقُ بِهِ is what? مَاءٌ. What does that all show you? عَمَلٌ يَسِيرٌ. Simple action. لَكِنْ أَجْرٌ كَبِيرٌ. وَاللَّهِ, this is حَدِيثٌ يَأْخُذُ بِالْأَلْبَابِ. وَاللَّهِ, this is a hadith that takes the person's heart. It moves the heart. This is a sadaqah of a بَغِيٌ مُسْتَحِقَّةٌ لِلْعِقَابِ. She deserves punishment. تصدقت على كلب من الكلاب. All she took care of was a dog from the dogs. بماء water اقتنته بلا مقابل. She didn't pay for the water. She didn't have to go through hardship to get that water. فكان الجزاء والثواب جنة. And the reward was جنة من الرحيم التواب. It was Jannah from the merciful one, the one that accepts every repentance of every slave. My sister, my brother, any one of you has done a lot of sins in life. That's how merciful Allah is, subhanahu wa ta'ala. That is how merciful Allah subhanahu wa ta'ala. Abu Dharr radiallahu ta'ala anhu, he said that the Prophet sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, he said, Ya Aba Dharr, The Prophet spoke to him, sallallahu alayhi wa sallam, and he addressed him. The Prophet said, Ya Aba Dharrin, Aba Dhar, إِذَا طَبَّخْتَ مَرَقَةً, if you make soup, you make yourself meat, فَأَكْثِرْ, increase in what? مَاءَهَا, add more water to your soup. وَتَعَاهَدْ جِرَانَكَ, and be consistent of taking care of your guests. And Imam Muslim narrated that. And Imam Abu Abdullah al-Qurtubi rahimahullah, the great scholar who wrote the Tafsir Kitab, he said, قال العلماء, but the scholars said, لما قال عليه السلام, when the Prophet said, فأكثر ماءها, increase in the water, نبه بذلك على تيسير الأمر على البخيل, تنبيها لطيفة. فأكثر ماءها, increase, add more water to it. This is gently telling the stingy one, but in a gentle way. Why? Because the one who's who's generous, he, even if it's no water added to Allah, he would still share that. Like in the bakhil is, if you don't want to add at least some water for it, at least take something to them. Even if it's small. وَجَعَلَ الزِّيَادَةَ فِيهَا لَيْسَ لَهُ ثَمَنٌ وَهُوَ الْمَاءِ, because what you added onto it is just water. And it doesn't cost you much. وَلِذَلِكَ لَمْ يَقُلْ أَبُو عَبْدِ اللَّهِ الْقُرْطُبِي, said. But the Prophet did not say, إِذَا طَبَّخْتَ مَرَقَةً فَأَكْثِرْ لَحْمَهَا, increase the meat. He might be saying, no, I don't want to, because he's stingy. He just said, يعني فأكثر ماءها, increase in the water. To show you that it's a small action, but a big deed. Look what then Abu Abdullah al-Qurtubi said, إِذْ لَا يَسْهُلُ ذَلِكَ عَلَى كُلِّ أَحَدٍ, that's not easy for everybody. Not everybody has enough meat to make the soup out of it. Then Abu Abdullah al-Qurtubi said, وَلَقَدْ أَحْسَنَ الْقَائِلُ قِدْرِي وَقِدْرُ الْجَارِ وَاحِدَةٌ وَإِلَيْهِ قَبْلِي تُرْفَعُ الْقِدْرِ, my pot and the pot of my neighbors is what? It's both the same. Okay? My qidr wa qidru al-jari wahidatun, our pot is the same. What I cook is for them and what they cook is for me. Are we like that, brothers and sisters? Or do we cook for ourselves and only ourselves? ولذلك the Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام, he said, يا نساء المؤمنات لا تحتقرن إحداكن لجارتها ولو كراع شاة محرقا. The Prophet عليه الصلاة والسلام, he said, يا نساء المؤمنات, O the believing women, لا تحتقرن, do not belittle, إحداكن لجارتها, for your neighbor, do not belittle, ولو كراع شاة محرقا, even a roasted shoulder trotter, whatever. Do not belittle it. Al-Imam Malik mentions that in his Muwatta. لهذا قال أهل العلم, and because of that, the people of knowledge, they say, القليل لا يمتنع التصدق به لحقارته. The little is not prohibited to give in charity because it's small. بل ينبغي التصدق به, بل ينبغي التصدق بما تيسر قل أو كثر. Rather, the person should give anything that they are able to do, whether it's small or little. The little is not prohibited to give in sadaqah because it's something you belittle. No, you give what you can. Okay, and it's the intention that matters. I'm going to stop there, inshallah ta'ala. Anything I might have said that was wrong or incorrect is from me and shaytan, and Allah and His Messenger are both free from it. Subhanakallahumma bihamdi, ashhadu an la ilaha illallah, astaghfiruka wa atubu ilayh.